What do you want?
Lots of water.
Four waters. Is that all?
Yes. No. I want the Villa Scalapine. I want a Fettuccine Alfredo. A bottle of Fettuccine, a 1981.
The only thing we serve is tongue. No. You boys like tongue?
Communion After Dark.
Loving you.
Look at me and tell me how much hope remains for me with this protuberance. Look at me. Look at me. Look at me.
Em sẽ nói anh nghe về tổn thương.
Oh, Communion After Dark, welcome back. It is the week of February 21st. I'm Mouse and I'm here with Paradise and Gold, and our special guest this week is Jay Taylor of Jaded.
Hello.
Hey, all right. Welcome back.
Thanks for having me back. I thought, to be perfectly honest, last time we spoke, I think Tom said they don't invite guests back, so I don't know what happened.
No, the guests don't want to come back.
What happened, Jay?
I got it the wrong way around.
So that was my set. The last song I played was brand new Trevor Something. He's back with a cover of The Cure with the song Love Song. And it's just a single that you can get. We know that he loves like Depeche Mode and The Cure, so I was super stoked for this version. We'll provide the Bandcamp links, by the way. If you ever look at our playlist, we have the links to all of the music.
Mm-hmm.
And then before that, the sixth song in my set was brand new The Birthday Massacre with their song Cold Lights. This is from their new album called Fascination that just came out finally. It's got more synthwave elements, a little bit slower than their other works, but it's nice and hard. And I absolutely love it. And that's on Metropolis Records. The fifth song in my set is by Stars Crusaders out of Italy. They have a new album that's coming up on February 22nd. That album will be called Mater, M-A-T-E-R. I played the song Hellmouth. I'm not sure how you pronounce it. That song was actually released 1 year ago as a single. So we played it a whole year ago. Probably don't remember it. But you can get it as a pre-order track if you pre-order that album out on Skycode Records.
All right, the fourth track in Mouse's set was by ESA. Their new release is Designer Carnage, and that was the title track, Designer Carnage, out on Bandcamp. And what was it, their label they're on? Negative Game. Yeah, mm-hmm. Thank you.
Negative Game Productions, yes. Good label. Third song Mouse played in the set you just heard was by Kim Lunner. Kim Lunner is out of Norway, and the track you heard was Take a Look in the Mirror, which is a single that came out on KLT Records. I love that name, KLT. It's like the old days.
In Cincinnati.
It's like Casey Kasem days.
KTEL Records.
KTEL, yeah, KTEL. I remember KTEL, yeah. But pretty cool. And it's a good song, too. I like that track.
It actually reminds me of Ruined Conflict.
It's good. I didn't know what to expect from that song because I really had never heard much by Kim Lunner before, but that is a good track.
Okay, the second song in my set is New My Love Kills out of Sweden. The song is called Back to Life. They have come back to life, so it sounds like they have some new music that's going to be coming out. It's just a single you can get right now on Progress Productions.
Yes.
Out of Sweden.
That's their new label they're on now. That's Friedrich, who of course was in the band Erotic Elk. And what was the band? And Ad Inferna? Man, I can't remember the guy's name that was in that band. But that's their new band that they've been doing now. And I've actually heard the whole album. Friedrich was so nice to send that over to me and let me preview it, and it's a great album. So very, very excited for that when that comes out. So looking forward to hearing that. All the stuff when it comes out.
All right. And I started out my set with Jaded. So we have Jaded, and the song was called A Little Time. And this is on the album Vision of Time, out on Infected Recordings. And there's, if you got the limited edition, there's some remixes on there as well. But truly excited that this is available now.
Yes, good stuff. Good stuff. Love that track. And the deluxe edition is out now too, with remixes by Rotter Sand and some other cool bands.
Yeah, as many remixes as I could get, it kind of felt like, to be honest. I was really lucky to be able to kind of pick up so many. Like one of the normal things, especially like working on Infected, is that Torben likes to do a little bit of a reach out with especially mm-hmm. bands who are like in connection or at least on the label. And yeah, everything that we got back was, there was nothing to put in the bin. So it all went on. They're all great.
Oh, that's awesome.
Great. Yeah, so it's cool. All right, we're going to talk more about this release, of course, coming up, but first, we're going to do our shot of the week with Jay. Let's go ahead and get to that.
It's the only reason I came back.
Yes. See, now it comes out.
I'm joking, of course.
Cheers.
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 Now drink your drink.
I watched
that was in
last
honor
week's
of Jay,
show.
By the way.
Oh, thank you.
We have a guest next week, which we want to make sure we announce real quick here. That is Morris Black is coming here next week. Morris Black is out of Boston, I believe, here in the States. And he's also on Negative Gain, which we mentioned earlier. So looking forward to having him. And also, remember, each week we do a video stream. We played a large amount of Jay's videos on there because we love Jay's videos. On our Twitch channel, which is Coming After Dark's Twitch channel. You can go to twitch.tv or just download the Twitch app and you can watch us. We're on there most Fridays at 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. So, yeah, you do some great videos, Jay. The last video that you did for, I believe it was it I'll Wait, if I'm not mistaken?
Yep.
Was that the last one? That was a really cool video. I enjoyed that one.
Yeah, I owe it all to my video guy Mark from Mondo Cheapo. Like I literally turn up and prance around for the day, and then he gets some great shots out of it. Mark will continue to do all the rest of the Jaded videos. We've got a really good working relationship, and it's nice to, as much as it's nice to have a physical CD, it's nice to have a video as well with every single. It just kind of feels right.
So. It looks, yeah, I like your videos. You do a good job with those, definitely. So. Check out his videos and check out our Twitch stream every Friday at 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. I know everybody's in a different time zone, so just kind of figure it out. I'm sure Google will tell you what time that is, depending on where you live. All right, Gold, go ahead and spin some music.
This is After Dark Radio, and you are listening to DJ Gold.
Walking up. always too much, never enough, always too much, never enough.
Never enough. Tal vez se tiende el agua. streets. You and I gonna be the secret it keeps. In the rain and the snow and the weight of the years, in the empty echoing city, gonna fade away, gonna turn to shades of gray. And we're all dying to go and disappear. In the empty echoing city, it'll be yesterday. You and I gonna burn in shades of gray. Is it something that brought this? I washed from its haunches to prolong this, the wrongness, the loss of your options. And loudly the clock ticks, you're spouting the toxins. And now you're unconscious, but somehow still the thought sticks. You bow and you fall sick, and doubt as you're daunted to shout with a hawk's pitch. And out come the foxes. What about the street from which the world retreats? You and I gonna be the secret it keeps. What about the sand that was slipping through your hand? I couldn't tell where it ended and you began. What about the smoke? What about the broken screens? What about the playing out of 80,000 hopes and dreams? What about the sand that was slipping through your hand? I couldn't tell where it ended and you began. I couldn't tell where it ended and you began. Oh! You're splitting you something else, a shift to the former self. A picture of the tower bells, rips open wide the shell. And count them all up to 12 insurmountable, raising hell. And the animals come to tell us what now is when they propel. Out of the deep, out of the bone, out of reality that you believed. That was your body, that was your soul. No, it was nothing except for the time being. A divine being that was hiding down inside me. But I know a scene, the last days of the Anthropocene. So get behind me. In the rain, and the snow, and the weight of the years, in the empty echoing city.
I'm listening. Thank you.
All right, welcome back to Communion After Dark. I'm DJ Tom, and you just heard Has What? From Spain.
Has What?
Has What?
I don't know.
From Spain. And there's a song called Monzu, which is, I guess, more like shut up or zip it.
No.
Zip it.
Zip it, shut up, shut your mouth. And that's from the same title track from the same album. And that's on Art Gates Records.
That's one thing I know how to say in Italian. Stat zit. It means shut up or zip it.
Yes. The only reason I know that is because
that's the only reason I know that.
Important words that we need to know,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, that's the only reason I know that is because my grandparents used to say it to each other all the time when I was growing up. So they probably thought that, you know, we would never learn what it meant, I guess.
Yeah, what a fun childhood memory.
Yeah, exactly.
The previous song before that we heard was brand new Soman from Germany, and the song was called Now Listen from his new Vision album out on Tresol Records. And then the fifth song in my set was by Irvardensphere from Canada, and the song was called Indominus from his new Rage Maker CD out on Metropolis Records.
Nice. All right, there we go. And fourth song, Gold Sub, was by Project Ish out of Germany, or Project. I'm not sure how you say that. I apologize. And the song you heard was Pictures in My Head. That's on the Pictures in My Head EP. And you can pick that up on Bandcamp. So, and that is Oof Mueller, who is actually the man who runs Echo Zone. And that is also his band that he does. And I believe, if I'm not mistaken, Gold, that song featured Espresso Maniki. I don't think it's like a coffee, though. It's Espresso Maniki. That's who that track features, because all Project Isha's songs usually have different guest vocalists on them.
That's underneath. All right. The third song in Gold Set was by Neuf out of Sweden, with the song Silicone Slut. I love that name. From their new release called Electro Acoustical Murder. Not sure if that's an EP or an album.
That's a full album.
Full album? Cool. Yep. And you can get it on Chordbug Music. Oh, Chordbug. Sorry.
Chordbug.
All right, so then the second song in my set, we heard Faderhead from Germany with a song called Always Too Much, Never Enough, from his new release Years of the Serpent on his label Not a Robot Records. And then started off with brand new Deathline International. They're back after a long hiatus with a song called Breaking from their new Pax America album out on Cop International.
Nice.
Yeah.
All right. Awesome news for Deathline International fans. Remember they did their big hit in the man, it was like in the 90s. I remember because we used to play that in the club like a long time ago, that Wild Boys cover.
Yeah, that they did a really good version of
Wild Boys.
Tainted Love, too.
Yeah, yeah. All right, so let's talk to Jay. Tom Mouse. Well, you have some wonderful questions for Jay for regarding his new stuff he's been doing?
Sure, I got a question. Not necessarily related to your new stuff, but you got some great melodies that you write. You're really great at the melodies. So how do you write that? Do you like work it out on a keyboard or hum it into a recorder while you're on the train?
So yeah, you're probably closer to the second example. So I will have melodies in my head that I will record on my phone. I'll look like one of those crazy people who's on a nice peaceful walk with my daughter on my shoulders, kind of singing some random song. And that's a real story. I've got one song from like the first album. I was walking round a lake in New Zealand with my daughter, and me and my daughter just came up with a melody. So yeah, little memories like that are nice as well. And then the rest of the time is me murmuring into a microphone over and over and over again until something sits right. So both times I look relatively crazy. but yeah, you just go with what sticks, don't you? Like with anything, if you can remember something quickly enough, and it comes back to you easily, then that's
a good melody.
That's the thing to go for, in my opinion.
Awesome.
Gold.
Well, I have a copy of your CD right here.
Oh, you got
who
it.
What's the story behind the artwork on it? Because I like the look of it. It matches the vibe of the album, I think.
Yeah, so I really do attempt to try and do my artwork in associated context theme within the release as well. That was the same with the first album. So with this one, like the concept of the album, and I don't realize these things when I start writing them, but because I'm constantly writing, I kind of generally find the context is a sort of period in my life. And don't get me wrong, I'm the same as everybody else. Everybody's been in some form of lockdown. My life probably changed quite a bit over the course of the last year and a half. And things have happened which I would never expect to have happened. So it's just kind of that thought process of that time is fragile and it can absolutely change anything. And then there's also a link back into one of the other songs on the EP called Evil in a Bottle. So that's why I've got this kind of kooky, spooky 13-hour clock inside a very fragile bottle.
Nice.
Links. Or tries to.
So last time Jay was on our show, which was we're in 2022 now, so 2021, early 2021, it was around the same time of 2021 last year.
Yep.
And you had at that time released your album A Complicated Genocide on Infected Recordings. So now this is the Vision of Time that you've released that came out just yesterday. Well, actually a couple days now, because this will be on Monday. Now, do you have anything? Is this like your full length album, or you have another follow up to this after this album is, you know, after this one? You have something else coming out this year still?
Yeah, so after this, I've already got all of the next EP, so it'll be a 7 original track EP. Everything is in final stages of production at the moment. I've been working like a dog. The only thing that you'll see visually different from me from last time is that my hair is longer and my face is probably fatter, because I have been sitting in this chair for a whole year making music. That's literally what most of my time has been filled up for, well, at least free time, that is. So yeah, there'll be another EP, 7-track EP later on this year, and I'm still working on starting on new tracks for release number 4. So I'm just writing as much as I can do to kind of
nice.
I'm so, in a good rhythm.
Yeah, and you're on Infected Recordings. We want to make sure that people know this, because I know people hear and things, they don't pay attention to much. And nowadays, I know how everything, it's like one thing goes in. But if you're listening to the show, remember, the Infected Recordings, check it out on Bandcamp. You can find Jay's music on there under, again, Mouse, how we say this? What's the name of the band?
Jaden.
There you go. Mouse has got it on.
Yeah,
she's
because...
like, she's like, on it!
Well, and, he told us.
Yeah, well,
it was like a play
right.
on words.
Jaden or Jade. You remembered.
Yes.
Mouse, yeah.
You did it. You did it.
She remembered.
Yeah. So it is, now, it's Jaded rather than Jay Dead.
Because that's how an American would say, like, Jay Dead, because we usually put our accent on that last syllable, but Jaded.
I mean, it's pretty close anyway. No one's going to notice too much. But yeah, Jaded is the way that I would say.
So go to, go to Bandcamp. Go wherever you want to buy your music and look up Infected Recordings, look up Jay's music, and give him some love. All the links are on our playlist, so you should be able to see that. If you're paying attention to our playlist, we put it everywhere, wherever our show is posted. Now, Jay, I have to ask one more question before we go to your set, and then we'll talk some more to you, because we have other questions, I'm sure. But this is just my opinion. I hear a large amount of black audio influences maybe I'm crazy, in your vocals. Not so much in your music, but in your vocals. And I'm not saying that you're copying anything like Black Audio, but I just hear the kind of influence. Is that a band that you listen to, or no? Or is that not somebody who you're...
So this is a good story, because when you mentioned it last time, I've had quite a few other people mention it as well since you mentioned it. And okay. I haven't really listened to them before.
Okay.
You know, I maybe hear the odd track or whatnot. So I have. I've got them on my Spotify. I regularly listen to them now. It's hard to judge yourself in terms of your own singing voice. I don't know how to connect it to any other artist in way. But some of their stuff is really cool. And look, one of the definite connections is that, look, I've had... my kind of live music career in sort of synthpop and EBM and industrial, and sure. I love that scene. But my kind of past is in metal and punk and rock and so on and so forth. So, you know, that's kind of where Davey Havoc was for a long period of time, wasn't he? So, yeah.
Well, that's true. Yeah, because because like with AFI and all that stuff, you know, and some of the other stuff he did. So, yeah, correct. It's just I think your singing voice is so well defined. That it's hard not to, like with everything, people want to compare you to other artists, but that goes to show how great of a voice you have when you're singing. You should be really, honestly, I haven't heard too many artists who've come out in this scene who have that depth that you have in your voice, where you're hitting different octaves when you're singing. More people need to be listening, for sure. I mean, because it's amazing music. I mean, I love... And especially if you're one of those people who loves just vocally driven music outside of the, obviously, the composition of the music itself. Your vocals just drive the music because you have such strong vocals. So it's great. We love it.
Really appreciate it. And I was slightly smirking when you were talking about going up the other octaves, because I can literally feel my face trying to get into that higher octave kind of range. It sounds all right, maybe, but it doesn't look so pretty.
Well, I can understand that part. That makes sense. All right. Well, we're going to hear a DJ set from you now, which is really awesome. All right. So come back for some Life Cried, and we'll talk to Jay here in a few moments.
Communion After Dark. We'll be right back.
was always a strife, gave meaning to our decay. Instead of searching for more of the time, we're undercover and play.
Shit about you. solid industry. But things can solve.
What thing?
Welcome back to Communion After Dark. My name's Jay Taylor. I am the singer and creator behind Jaded, or Jay Dead. However you want to say it, Mark, it is purely up to you.
I'm trying.
Say it any way you like, and I will support you. I will support you, Mark. It's fine. the last song in my set was Pack Psychosis from Grendel. Grendel's kind of got a big connection to my heart in this music scene for quite a few reasons. Grendel was the first band that I liked in this scene, that I loved in this scene, which wasn't the only band that I was playing in at the time, which is Tactical Sex. So I owe Grendel a lot, and my lots of reasons. Also in my personal life, like my girlfriend is the ex-keyboard player from Grendel as well. So Grendel is a part of my life in one way or another, so it definitely deserves.
I remember her in the band.
Yeah.
We love Grendel.
Yeah, look, his stuff.
Are you waving at Grendel?
Raven, if he's listening,
hey,
or if he's watching, yeah.
Hey, JD, how's it going, dude?
JD lived in Florida for a while.
He
so
did. Of course he did.
Yeah. We actually had we recorded actually one of the Coming After Darks a while back, when we were still recording live in our studios, and then he was here. Doing that with us, so which was actually pretty cool. So yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, no, he's a good guy. Before that was You Did This by Gencab. Gencab are back. I'm gonna say the same as everybody else, but I really, really like David's style of writing. I think it is personally quite unique within the scene, to be perfectly honest. There is, for me personally, there's all of these kind of hardcore and metal sort of early 2000 influences within there, which I really, really like. So
yeah, I want to point out too, that song which you just played, that's another artist on Negative Gain. So yep. Negative Gain should be like loving us by this point.
I'll be typing up my commission.
Yeah, it's like really.
Just no, no one mention any more Negative Gain. I'll try not to. But, yeah, good label. What about that Infected, right? What about that? Anyway.
Yeah, exactly. No, in fact, we love. Hey, I love Torben. I love Torben.
No, he's an amazing guy.
Yes.
Before that was Easier Than Lying by Halsey. A bit of a different one to maybe expect on here, and the one before that as well. I'm maybe going to get an absolute kicking for this set list. I did think that beforehand, but thought no. Be strong. Let's try it. Easier Than Lying was produced and mixed by Atticus Ross and Trent Reznor. That's why I love it. You can hear that throughout that whole of that album. That is probably one of the biggest albums for me for last year. It's fantastic, in my opinion. Before that was Violence, and I never thought I would ever even be saying these words. I'm really sorry, okay? But by Grimes and Io. I've never listened to Grimes before in my life, nor am I overly interested. However, I think the more and more I've been spending time making music, the more and more I appreciate just when someone gets their production absolutely spot on. So for me, that song in terms of production is amazing. And also, I would strain everybody to, I'm trying to sell this right, bear with me. If you listen to the drums in that mix, that is most industrial kind of like typical mix that you would find in lots of different stuff. It's a great drum.
Nice.
Anyway. Before that was Imaginary Fire by Carpenter Brute featuring Greg. Greg is from Dillinger Escape Plan. Again, one of my favorites from back in the day. Miss Machine is probably one of my favorite albums ever, but I think that's a fantastic track as well. Before that was Pumped Up Kicks by Three Teeth. I can no longer hear the original version of that song. It does not make sense anymore. Go Three Teeth, good for you. And the first song in my set was Bloodstained by Life Cried. And yes, Life Cried were on Neutek. I did a tour with Chris and the guys a very, very long time ago with Tactical Sect. And obviously he did a remix for me for the new EP as well. So hello to Chris. Thank you very much. Your songs are great.
That's awesome. Yeah, I outside of your own music, of course, I miss Tactical Sect. Those were good days. Great.
I didn't have the balls to play it, right? But in here, there is an unreleased Tactical Sex song. That I was considering playing, but then I thought, oh, no. If I haven't told Anthony, he would really tell me off.
Yeah, Anthony would be like...
Just do it and ask for permission later.
No. One time I'll ask him permission, but... As I was getting it ready, I'm like, oh, do I? No, it's not right. But I was close.
Before we go to our last set of the show, which is my set, Jay, so with the new album, I'll Wait, do you have a particular favorite track on that? I mean, I love the two singles you've released so far. I mean, they're amazing. And the rest of the album is excellent as well. It's all good from front to back. But did you have like a favorite or like something that, just, you know, one of those tracks that just means so much to you on that album that you want to talk about?
So again, you know, in terms of meaning, because all of those songs were kind of finally written time period, it's more so the release that's got an associated meaning for me. But and don't get me wrong, I go through waves with my own songs as well in terms of what I like and what I really dislike. So I'm really liking Afraid at the moment. You know,
the new EP again is called Vision of Time. Not I'll Wait, which I just stated, which is stupid. I apologize. But anyways, we mentioned earlier, this is great stuff. So check it out. It's on Infactor Recordings. And Jay will be sticking around with us. We're going to listen to some more music coming up. If you haven't had a chance, though, go back as well and listen to Jay's first album, Complicated Genocide, which is great. There's some good videos on that, too. And you, like I said, whoever that guy you mentioned earlier that does your videos, guys do a great job with the videos. He is top notch. Yeah, I really enjoy him. So he knows how to put everything together and make it look well, which I guess is not the easiest thing to do because there are videos that come out that just look like they are not really that much thought put into them. Let's put it that way. But anyways,
he does all the work. Like I said earlier, I literally turn up and prance around and then he does all of the magic.
Yes. So Vision of Time again will be is now out on Infactor Recordings, and that came out just a couple of days ago. And again, there are remixes as well. If you like remixes by Lights Euphoria, Rodersant, our buddy Gary Watts of Nature Wires, who is we love. I mean, he's a great guy.
He says hi, by the way. I got a message from the other day. He says,
hi, Gary. Gary. Yeah, Gary does a great job with his music. Mm-hmm. The St. Paul remixed you. So Technovore, which is a band now that is on Infected. And Life Cried. Yep. So some good stuff on there. And Life Cried, which we were just talking about.
Well, are the mixes only on the CD? It's not the regular digital, is it?
No, all the remixes are on physical only. Yeah. So I have my last couple of copies here. I think I've got 5 or 6 copies left of physical edition here with me. The rest will be with Infected, or you can get them on places like Infrarot or Hoppernaut, but we only did more.
You gotta get the physical.
All right. Nice. That's smart though. I like that because you're actually offering something different for the physical. Which makes sense. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so check that out and then come back for more music and we'll talk to Jay some more. We'll also read off our donations for the week to everybody who continues to help us run this show. We appreciate it and see you soon.
This is Communion After Dark Radio and you are listening to DJ Paradise.
Absolut glücklich. Werdet ihr glücklich. Glücklich.
fly when I'm away. I can fly when I'm awake.
Oh,
All right, welcome back to Communion After Dark. I am Paradise. You just heard my set, the last set of our show, music-wise. Don't go anywhere, though. We have other things to talk about. Plus, we have another song coming up before the show is over with. The last song you heard was by Pure Obsession and Red Knights. That is a band out of France. Don't Let the Night Die in Vain. So that is the name of the track. It's a single that you can pick up through Bandcamp. I believe they also have like a French label that they release their music on normally. But that was a band that originally was called Porn a while back, and they sounded different. You know, they've completely changed their sound up, and this is their new style that they've been doing. Great, great track. Love it. The fifth track in my set was by Safiria V, who is out of New York or here in the States. And the song you heard was In My Sleep. That is off her brand new album called Aerial Human, which you can pick up on Distortion Productions. And I want to thank Jim from Distortion for sending me over that album. Much appreciated.
Okay, the fourth track in Paradise's set was by Der Wolfmensch. Or is it Wolfmensch? But they're out of Canada. So I'm just going to say it like a W, Wolfmensch. That was the song Broken, and it's a single that you can get self-released on Bandcamp.
Yep. Der Wolfmensch is Marco from Decoded Feedback.
That's right. Yep. He's been releasing singles for quite a while now under that name. Man, if you go to his actual Bandcamp and look up his name, he's released a ton of singles.
Cool.
The third track in Paradise's set was by Urban Matrix from Germany, and let's try this. Glucklish, Octung. And that's self-released on Bandcamp.
Glucklish.
Glucklish is the name of the song.
Okay, yep, that's the name of the song.
Oh, the album's called, okay. Glucklish from the album Octung.
Octung, yeah, exactly. Yep, there you go. Good stuff. Octung. Yeah, it's good stuff. If you like power electronics, that is the album for you for sure. No doubt. That is good stuff. It's power industrial electronics. Definitely straight at you from that album. Kind of like old Fine Flute, now that we were talking about them earlier. Yeah. Second track in my set was by Kem out of Russia. And the song you heard was Biznaz. And that was on their album Aorta, which you can pick up on Insane Records.
Business.
None
of your business.
Yeah.
Exactly. Business. All right. I start off with a band on Infactor Recordings. The song was, yeah, band's called Technovore out of Greece. And the song you heard was Anachronist. That is on the new EP that's coming out. It's a 4-track EP. It's not released yet. This is the only song that is currently available, and you can get that through the Infactor Recordings Bandcamp. I apologize to Mouse because Mouse wanted to play this song originally.
Pull it right out of my set.
And I did not see that Mouse was actually wanting to play this, and I played it instead, so I apologize. But good stuff. I haven't heard this band before. They're more along the lines of like Siva 6, who's also, I believe, out of Greece. Very similar sound.
So it's the so George is Technovore, and George is also from Kruna.
Kruna, okay.
And it was a Creative Strike.
Back
a few years ago. So I did some work with George. For a collaboration song called Tearing Me Apart. So that's Technovore there. And there may be some more things to come.
So, nice. Yeah, it's good. I really like that track. It's you know, definitely harder, industrial sounding, electronic, EBM, whatever you wanna announce it. But I went with a little bit more of a darker electro sound on my set. So I hope you enjoyed it. All right, there we go. So, Mouse, you're next. I guess sure. If we're going to read our donations, if you want to go ahead and do those real quick.
Okay. So, thank you guys so much for your donations. Remember, you could go to our website, www.communionafterdark.com, and our donation buttons are on there. All of these are monthly donations. So thank you, Lance Cooley, for a double monthly donation. Megan Hunter, who we know.
Hi, Megan.
Anders Shao Naughton, Thomas During from The Purge, Rebecca Van Herk out of Perth, Australia, Donald Sylvia. We also got Pandemus Rex, who is a new monthly donation from Washington. Hi, Pandemus. Jens Ara Amundsen, James Trimarco, David Scott, Jonathan Moser, Andrew Bateman, Gary Watts from Nature of Wires, Mark Steele, Denizen Kane, Dirty Juicy, David Munoz, Edgar Martinez, Mr. Nobody, Stephen Wiedner out of New York is a new monthly donation. Hi, Stephen. Welcome. And Adam Saman. So thank you guys so much for donating monthly. And then we did get a one-time donation from Aaron Reed, who says, next drinks on me, which is awesome.
All right. Aaron. Thanks, Aaron.
And Amy Dark, who says, all the hugs to CAD. And she is one of the members of our new Discord VR chat after dark. And I think she's also on EBM Worldwide. So if you're on Discord, you'll find Amy.
Nice. Yeah, and thank you to everybody who continues to help us out. And it's really awesome. We had two new monthly donators to the show this week, the donors to the show this week, which is fantastic. That hasn't been happening recently, so we really appreciate that. It's awesome. Much love. And yeah, thank you to everybody who continues to help us run this show every week. Our goal, again, with the show has always been the same, to highlight the artists that we play and for you to hopefully go buy their music. We try and put everything on our playlist. I think we do more than most shows for playlists. I mean, I'm not just saying that because, you know, we put where you're from, we put the name of the album, we put the name of the song, we put the name of the label, if there's a label, we put the link where you can buy it. So there's not much more. I don't really think there's much more we can do.
We can't do anything else, guys.
I think we've covered it with the playlist.
That's about as good as a roadmap as you're going to get.
Yeah, that's exactly. Pretty much it. So, I mean, if you if you're interested in buying music or purchasing the tracks, all you have to do is look at our playlist, and all the information is on there for you. And of course, the link is there, which you can click on to go buy the track wherever that track may be available. So there you go. And Jay, so we want to, talk a little bit more, and then we'll go to the last song, and then we'll maybe have a few more questions. But I will let Mouse and Gold throw out some more questions if they have any.
So what's next for Jaden? So between
now and the EP towards the end of the year, and I don't know when that will be, but there will be one. That's all I know. I'll have another single and another video from this EP, so from Vision of Time. I have in the mix at the moment, I was calculating this up the other day, I have 11 unreleased tracks at the moment that are not connected to any of my own future stuff. These are all collaboration singles or remixes. Like I said, I've been sitting here for a whole year, so you will hear something Jaden related every single month this year without a shadow of a doubt. That's the aim anyway, so we'll see if that happens. But yeah, so I've got a load of stuff there, and then shows. So hopefully with the world starting to open up a little bit more, Jaden can do what I wanted it to do in the first place and go out and
awesome. Do you have a show set up that you're gonna be doing soon, or like in the near future, or is that still not announced yet?
No, so there's one booked for Hanover in July, I think, off the top of my head. So that's booked, but we're still looking for stuff before and after that. I think Germany now, as an example, and kind of most of Europe are just starting to reopen again for shows properly, which are at, you know, decent level of capacity. So, you know, we've got to get rolling with that. But then again, look, it's hard for everybody. It's hard for the promoters at the moment because they obviously they've got to rebook everybody that they've cancelled for the last 2 years.
Right, exactly.
So, you know, the shows this year will be few and far between, but there will be more, and then there'll be hopefully loads more next year, because that, right, as I said, that's the whole aim for the project, to get out on the road.
Fantastic. Yeah, so check that out, you know, when he plays live, whenever that may be. If you live in Europe, I wish I could see more of these shows, because I know how much
I've got to come to Florida.
Yes, Jay, there you go. Come to the States and play in Florida. I would love that. That would be amazing. We really honestly do not get enough artists along your status, or your, you know, even the labels that you're, you know, like Infected labels or anything like that, to play over here. So it would be amazing if you're able to do something like that. I would love to have you. No doubt about that.
Just say, yeah, man, we'll sort of, if people want to see us there, we'll play. As long as it,
yeah,
as long as
we can
make
it work, hey,
you know, with that.
I would love to have you over here. And I think that, I hope more people that listen to the show, you know, delve into some of the artists that we play. So I definitely believe you have a crowd over here. It's just, you never know with the States because it's so spread out. You never know where are the best places to play. But I mean, Florida, yes, come to Florida, and we would love to have you over here for sure. No doubt about that. I would love for you to come. So I'm going to finish off, and then we'll speak a little bit more. But the last song I set was by, it's going to be by Claustrophobia, which is a band out of the UK where Jay lives. And the song you're going to hear is Your Silent Face, which you should know if you're a New Order fan. I'm a huge New Order fan, as many of you know, if you've listened to the show for any number of years. This is a cover, and enjoy, and I love New Order. Come back, we'll talk some more. We'll be right back. All right, we're back. So thank you, Jay, again so much for coming on our show. It has been an amazing time. And well, at least for us, we really appreciate you being on.
And for me.
Yeah. Oh, good. I'm glad you've enjoyed it. I mean, we appreciate it. Yeah, we never know.
You're not pissed, or you might come back.
Yeah, because we're a little our show's a little crazy, and we're a little crazy, but we appreciate you enjoying it and chiming in with us and joking with us, because we try and have fun on this show. I mean, I know most of the time people appreciate it, but every once in a while, you have people be like, "Why are you acting so crazy?" But it's, you gotta have fun. You gotta have fun. Fun.
I'm not that serious. I'm really not.
Have fun. Listen to music. That's what the show is about. It's always been about that. But Jay's new album again is called Vision of Time. It's a limited edition CD. You can pick up physically, which has got, as we mentioned, many remixes on it. We already talked about the remixers. You can also pick up digitally if you are not, if you don't want the remixes, that's fine. It's available through Infactive Recordings Bandcamp or limited CD. Again, like Tom and Jay were talking about earlier, there's only so many copies left. A great place to pick up physical CDs if you're one of those people who enjoys buying music and holding on to it is, well, Jay mentioned the labels earlier, the sites, Infrarot, but Papanot is a great site to go to. I bought many, many releases. I know Tom buys countless releases from Papanot, and they have very reasonable shipping prices, great service. So if you want to buy physical copies, definitely check out papanot.de. So Jay, before we head off into the sunset, I guess, now that the songs are over with, I want to go over a few more things here with the new release that you put out. We've already talked that, you know, you have all these collaborate with all these people who remix your album. You've released a single so far, I'll Wait, which there's a video for. We also have a video out for, Hold Tight? Is that the one? Or was it Afraid?
Hold Tight will be the next single that comes out. So that's the video that we're planning for at the moment. So that will be the next single release. So yeah, only two singles from this one. I'm kind of considering what I do with the next EP, actually, whether I do three singles or two singles again. But those are the two that have videos. There will be another video of Afraid. What we're also planning at the moment is to do a live video of Afraid. Overdub it with live instruments as well, so it'll kind of give as much of a live feel as possible.
Nice. And you can check out his videos again on YouTube. And are they they're through, and does Infactive Recordings have their own I can't remember, YouTube channel, or
I don't think it does. So all of the videos will be on my YouTube,
through your YouTube. Mm-hmm. Perfect.
Yes,
all right, great. So I personally think you will love this new release. If you enjoy the Complicated Genocide, or if you haven't heard it, check it out and then pick up this one as well, Vision of Time. It is amazing. Great music, great melodies, great rhythm, fantastic production. Now, do you do your own production work, Jay, or do you work with somebody who helps you out?
No, I'm not going to be one of these artists that pretends that, you know, I write the theme tune, sing the theme tune kind of thing. So it's I have a production team, so I write all of the songs, all of the composition and lyrics and everything else is all by me. But I haven't got the production ability as the team that I use. So Hilger and Andreas are from Motel Music, who are my producers, who do all the final production on it. But they're also the live members of my band as well. So Hilger's going to be playing bass and Andreas is going to be playing drums. Andreas, I've known for quite a long time and played drums with him as well, because he is the second live drummer for some of the larger shows for Tuscaloosa.
Nice. Yeah, that's right, because we've talked about that previously when you were on the show, that you played with Tiska Luter live, and you know, you did drums for that band. So excited for sure. Now you will not, WGT is coming up this year, hopefully, maybe, we think it will. You're not planning on playing this year, correct? I don't believe.
So Tuscaloosa have got two larger size festivals this year, just with everything that's been going on. So the first one is the Sinner's Day in Belgium.
Okay.
So that's pretty cool. So there's a really good lineup there.
Yeah, it's awesome.
Multiple stuff.
Amazing.
And then the other one is Mariluna. So we've got Mariluna in August.
Okay. And so J-Deb will hopefully be on. I hope I get to see you on Wave Gothic Treffen. Maybe next year.
Let's cross our fingers for
next year. Yeah, because that would be amazing.
Everyone will hear of it by that time.
But J-Deb,
I keep going the way I'm going and just releasing loads of shit.
Oh, for sure. No, you definitely. You deserve a large amount of recognition for all the effort you've put into your music and the production quality, and it sounds great. I mean, there's no. When you listen to your music, and this, you know, you don't have to adjust the volume, which is nice. So the quality of the actual recordings are really well done. And
and to give a note as well, because, you know, I've really got to plug the people who make me pull Jaded together. I can't just say it's all me. So Chris Jam, who is from Rotterdam. Okay. He does all of my mastering. He's also the live engineer for pretty much most of the other bands that I play live with. Christian did a fantastic job on the mastering as well. Did
a really That's nice. Job. Yeah, he's a very talented artist. We appreciate Jay, and thank you very much. You're one of our favorites. We will have you back again whenever you're ready, and I'm sure there'll be more music to talk about because you're pretty active now, which is awesome, making releases, putting out new stuff. So maybe later in the year or next year when your stuff comes out again, we'll talk some more.
Sounds good. Thanks for having me. Appreciate it.
Thank you, Jay.
Thank you.
Bye.
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 Okay. All right. Ready? We're going to do a shot of the week. I got to get mine open here. I'm just doing a I have 99 blackberries.
99
right. Oh my God.
What do you got, Gold?
I got Apple Crown Royal.
Okay. And Jay, what do you got?
I have got a special edition Jack Daniels. I've got White Rabbit Jack Daniels.
Oh, nice.
I've had that before. That's good.
Mouse, you got something crazy, I'm sure, again.
No, it's not crazy because last week's shot killed me. This is just straight... salted caramel Baileys. I didn't mix it because I don't want it to coagulate.
No, you didn't throw any like antifreeze in it or anything.
No, I ran out of that stuff. All right.
You know, getting back to that day in Germany, I was so messed up that I was at the merch booth, and I saw this thing, and I go this box, it said Feinflug on it. I'm like, is that a Feinflug box? And they didn't understand me, so I bought it. So I thought it had CDs in it, but it's just a metal.
It's just a fret.
And it's numbered. And I bought it, but so I had them hold on to it at the counter.
I remember that.
Those are the things that we used to adorn on the curtains around the merch stands back in the day. It's just like, oh my God, let's make this camo look slightly nicer. Okay, put a metal frame of a band logo up there.
I think it was like 50. I think this was like 30 or 40.
I remember that, Gold. I remember when you bought that. And I remember you being like, this is
so disappointed when you turn it around and it's just a frame.
Because it was all wrapped up. It was all wrapped up in the back. And I'm like, oh, there must be like CDs in it or something.
This is special.
Decoration, a fine flute decoration.
Yeah, it's a metal picture, but it's numbered and everything on the back. Yeah.
Will someone turn off that music?
That's enough. I'm putting an end to this freak show right now.
Mm-hmm.